So I think sponsorship is really important. If we can get some of these children in school, they can lead a next to normal life or a somewhat normal life.
You know, walked and picked these kids up at school. I've never seen more kids so excited and just run and grab you and jump and are so thrilled. These kids are treated so poorly at school because they're orphans, but the second we showed up, everyone was, you know, so thrilled, and they were celebrities for a day, and it definitely made a difference, I think, in their school lives.
Hey, America, it's us, Heart4Africa, day 16. It's March 6th today. Very special day, Thursday here. We're under the tent of Gospel Lighthouse Church, and we have a very special event planned for today that you guys have empowered us to do here. So we wanted to bless you and bring you the news back on this very special day. Today is going to be the birthday party for all of the children.
Someone asked us before the birthday party started if this is how American children have birthday parties, and we told them, actually, no, this is bigger than what American children even get.
So how many here has ever been to a birthday party? Put your hands up.
I know I'm gonna work at you.
Who here has ever had a birthday? We're gonna have the biggest birthday party.
Leo hii tunaenda kuwa na party kubwa sana
in Kenya.
Hapa Kenya.
All of you,
nyinyi wote,
are gonna have a birthday party today.
Mutaenda kuwa na sherehe ya party day yenu hapa.
At the same time.
Mara hapa siku ya leo.
All going to be
sisi wote tunaenda kuwa
kings and queens. So guess what? You guys are all going to get dressed up like kings and queens.
I think that dressing them in princess costumes and Spider-Man capes and crowns and all of that, I think it brought a level of identity to them that I think that they had never experienced. I think at that moment that they felt that the adults loved them so much, and it was our proof of our love for them. And so I think that it was a moment of just realizing that they are really special, and it was proven by how we dressed them and how we treated them. And all of the other adults there, the Africans, they were even amazed as well, which was really nice to see. To see them watch us love their children.
One of the highlights of the birthday party was giving the kids their costumes and seeing them try them on and run around. And you know, James, the one little boy, was Superman, and he just kept running around in circles like he was flying. And some of the girls, princesses, were curtsying, and some of the kings, you know, just walking around with chest, you know, so proud and so high. And it just really, they took on another, you know, personality, and they just felt so royal. And that's exactly what we were trying to do. They know that they have a birthday. Some of them don't know what month, what day, even the year, so they're not even sure of their age. So we thought that it would be amazing to just do this huge event for them to be able to recognize that they have, you know, they are special, and that there is a day specifically for them, and that they can be spoiled and have a great time. They've never received gifts before or had cupcakes and had anyone sing to them. We provided all of that for them. We gave them costumes, which I've never seen kids light up so much when we did that for them. We got them all princess and king outfits, some knight outfits, Superman, Batman. It was definitely the most amazing experience I've had thus far.
After these last 2 weeks of playing with them, feeding them dinner, giving them showers, they've been very open to physical touch. They talk more with us, we can have a conversation with them. They smile a lot more, they're not afraid. The little babies are no longer crying when they see us. They actually reach out for us. So a lot has changed in just the last week.
The spirits of the kids completely have changed from the beginning of the week till now. When we first showed up, they wouldn't talk to us. They hid in a corner. They were so shy. No communication whatsoever. Any communication was by the workers, definitely. They wouldn't touch us, they wouldn't hold our hands. They don't know how to hug people. But now it's amazing. They run to us, they jump, they talk, they hug us. We had to teach them how to hug, but now they're able to hug us. This experience has definitely exceeded my expectations for the trip. Getting to know these 26 kids only in a matter of a couple of days have really shown that you can really truly care about someone and want the well-being for someone and love them so much that you want only the best for them. It wouldn't be a surprise if all 12 of us took someone home in our backpack with us. You know, we really care so deeply about them and only want the best for them. We're so excited because this afternoon we're going to be moving all these kids into a new home. Looked all week. It's been quite challenging to be able to find a place. There's several places available. However, letting the owner know that we're moving in all these children into a four-bedroom home has been a big challenge, as it would be even in the States. In Kenya, necessarily, the kids are not top priority. They are the bottom priority. And I think that with us being here and trying to show and educate people that kids are the number one priority and try to give them that mentality that kids are number one and that the orphans should be treated properly and taken care of, that maybe it'll get, start changing the minds of some of the African culture to let them know that they need to really care for and treat these kids well.
Getting them into a home that is secure and beautiful, like it is like the icing on the cake from the royal birthday party. It's like they've been treated like royalty since we've been here, and now it's really a reality. They're moving into a castle compared to what they've been living in for the past several years.
It's going to definitely be a culture shock for them. I don't know if they're going to be able to wrap their little brains around it right away. It might take them a while to realize that this is their new home. They're going to be able to play outside. Right now, they can't play outside. There's so many street kids, and it's just not safe for them. And they live in the slums. So we're moving them out of the slums into a really wonderful, amazing gated community, and just for the little bit of $450 a month.
Our plan was to dress their orphanage up like a castle, make it look festive, and now we're actually making it a reality. We don't have to dress it up, it really is a castle to them, and that is probably gonna be a lifelong changing experience for all of them.
Down and wiped our tears away, stepped in and saved the day. But once again I say amen, and it's still raining. But as the thunder rolls, I barely hear you whisper through the rain, I'm with you. And as your mercy falls, I'll raise my hands and praise the God who gives and takes away. And I'll praise you in this storm, and I will lift my hands, for you are who you are, no matter where I am. And every tear I've cried, you hold in your hand. Never left my side, and though my heart is torn, I will praise you in the storm. I remember when I stumbled in the wind, you heard my cry to you and raised me up again. My strength is almost gone, how can I carry on if I can't find you. But as the thunder